The truth is, magazines are full of sex because sex appeals to us. If we weren't interested in it, we wouldn't buy the magazines. But what if you're not wired like everyone else? What if you just don't want sex? Tessa is a 22-year-old virgin with no intention of changing.
It's hard to imagine what would push me to having sex.
21-year-old Andy has had sex, but never wants to do it again.
There's always been some sort of confusion about my sexuality. I've tried sex, but it's not something I'm just urged to do.
And 23-year-old Nikki has given it her best shot and still doesn't like sex.
First guy I ever slept with was Alex, and that was outside, in a very spontaneous, I've just become legal kind of a way, and I want to see what everyone else has been raving on about. In the pub. So we slept together a few times. It was quite a bit of experimentation. And then there's a couple of one-night stands. Then there was a holiday romance. I thought, you know, maybe English guys just aren't doing it for me. So, yeah, there was a Spaniard. You know, even after a few guys, I thought, well, I'm attracted to women as well, so maybe I'm just gay, I'm not bi. And I went through a bit of a dilemma over that. When I really like someone, it's been quite disappointing because I've wanted to feel something. And it just seems like a really long, arduous process for nothing, really. Because I don't feel the intimacy. I don't understand why people get horny and why all of a sudden they need to do this and they become like animals. And I just don't get all that. So for me, it's quite boring and repetitive. And sometimes it can just be really tedious if it's going on forever.
Tessa, Andy and Nikki all believe they're asexual and never want to have sex.
For me, the worst thing about sex is that it exists. And if it didn't exist, then that would make life a lot easier for me. I wouldn't have to fake climax and feel like I was being dishonest and, you know, they weren't doing what they wanted for me. So if it didn't exist, that would be a lot easier.
For most of us, asexuality is an alien concept. It's not the same thing as being celibate. You can choose to be celibate, whereas Tessa, Andy and Nikki feel they have no choice.
Some people find the concept of asexuality incredibly difficult to grasp. They don't understand how you can be human and not want sex.
Can I just tell me what I had to do?
Well, I'm trying to put it there.
I haven't had my hair straightened in ages. I feel like a rag doll.
Tessa's sister Jenna finds it hard to get her head around it.
So do you reckon it ever will change? How do you feel? Do you even think you've tried enough?
Yes, I put my profile up on every asexual dating site there is.
No, I mean, tried enough to see if you changed, you know, to feel differently, to feel like everyone else does.
I tried for long enough to know that it's certainly not something I'm comfortable at the moment.
Oh. Yeah, but being... Most people are uncomfortable with it when they first start out. Maybe that's
I'm 22, Jenna.
Maybe it is just finding the right person that you feel completely comfortable with.
I felt completely comfortable with both of my boyfriends. I trusted them completely. I really enjoy kissing and I enjoy making out and I enjoy cuddling and all that, but my entire body just revolts as soon as it gets too sexual. It's the biggest turn off for me.
Are you sure that's not just something that you built up in your mind,
no,
like a mental block?
It's not psychosomatic. It's not.
But how do you know that? Maybe you should get hypnosis and see if there is.
I've been to counselling for it. I was suggested by a doctor to go to counselling and talk about it. And there's nothing in my past that I can peg to being able to cause a phobia of it. And you're certainly better at this than I am, you know.
Although Andy has no interest in sex. He does his best to fit in.
Sometimes it's hard being asexual because there's so much talk about sex around. You know, if you go on a night out, you know, it's inevitable that sex will come into that at some point, you know. For me, it can be quite isolating knowing that people are sort of having these feelings and I'm not.
If you have done it, stand up. Yeah, I'm ready. I've never got so drunk that I've wet myself.
Yes. Well, I've never had a f***ing work.
Sex in the city. Really hurts. Can I just ask, have you stood up for everything here? I mean, half the stuff they do does shock me, to be honest. But, you know, that's part of, you know, that's part of my world, I guess. So, you know.
After years of trial and error, Nikki has found it better to be honest about who she is. Even with new workmates, she's only known for a couple of weeks.
I'm asexual. On the pull and you're like, you know, I need to get off kind of thing. I really don't get that.
So even kissing or anything, like anything physical?
Kissing's alright. There's some asexuals that like hate all bodily contact and are completely repulsed by sex. I'm not like that, I'm just disinterested.
Girls are very hormonal anyway, with different things that happen to their bodies. Sometimes they're exactly the same, but yeah. They wouldn't technically be asexual.
I don't get that choice, and I never get the want to. I want emotion and intimacy, but I don't want the act. And to me, sex is a bit like just sticking bits of anatomy in each other.
Really?
So, well, yeah, because if you think about it, kissing is like sticking your tongue in and waggling it round, swapping spit and then, yeah.
Do you see yourself?
No. Sometimes I wish I could just be normal.
Yeah.
I really do. And I tried so hard and
it's... Would you sacrifice your happiness to force yourself to be normal?
The hardest part is finding relationships, because anyone else you don't have to tell, you don't have to go into it or anything.
Yeah.
That's one of the reasons why one of my relationships broke up, because neither of us, you know, had spoken about it. Yeah, and...
Again, it really wouldn't bother you, not just to... Nothing.
If someone said to me, no, you will never ever have to have sex again, I'd be like, thank that. I really would. I'd be like, excellent, you know, I'd just watch telly or something.
But if you've given up on sex, do you have to give up on love?
I think the worst thing about being asexual is if you're trying to find a partner, unless you're prepared to compromise and you're indifferent to sex, then finding another asexual was really, really difficult and like looking for a purple fish in a big ocean full of silverfish, basically. It's strange and hard. There we go. Looks like an egg, doesn't it?
I can't stop this feeling I've got. I know who I am and I know what I'm not.